Welcome to Combo. Basil here, comparing an HTC Desire 500 with an HTC One. The HTC One is the flagship HTC phone for 2013. Introducing Sense 5, it was a revelation, really, really putting HTC on the map all over again. The HTC Desire 500 is the mid-range offering, but it also crams Sense 5 in there, making it the lowest-end Sense 5 device to date. But how does the flagship compare against this mid-ranger? Well, we're going to start off by talking about the design, and as you can see, the all-metal HTC One looks almost flawless. The HTC Desire 500 carries some of the same features, like a tapered edge, for example, but it couples it with a plastic body. It's not a unibody like the HTC One. The back cover is indeed removable, and if we take it off, we can see it encases the phone very, very elegantly, and couple that with NFC, sits quite nicely. Underneath the back cover, you've got micro SD expandability, not to mention a micro SIM slot. Slipping that back in there, feeling quite like a sensation, the way the case envelops the phone itself, we can start talking about other elements of the design. As far as buttons go, both devices have a volume rocker on the right hand side, a micro USB port at the base, and no buttons to the left. There's a micro SIM slot to the left hand side of the HTC One. Up at the top of both phones, you've got a power button and volume rock, 3.5mm headphone jacks. The displays are also very, very different. While they both pack LCD screen technology, you've got a full HD resolution display on the HTC One and a QHD display on the HTC Desire 500. This QHD display gives you a PPI of 216, whereas that of the HTC One is over double that. Yes, so that's really, really impressive, and side by side you really do see the difference. Still, the HTC Desire 500 does look perfectly bright and is very responsive to the touch, as you should be able to make out. At the front, you've got BoomSound speakers. That's two speakers on the HTC One for incredible audio quality, as well as a front-facing camera. Front-facing camera on the HTC Desire 500, but no BoomSound. As far as the rear-facing cameras go, you've got an ultra-pixel camera on the HTC One loaded with image stabilization. This means your handshake will be compensated for, and low-light shots are going to be that little bit better. The higher resolution camera on the HTC Desire 500 comes in at 8 megapixels in contrast to 4.3 on the HTC One, but it doesn't pack this advanced technology, so low light shots won't be quite as on point. Still, both have flashes and both should perform perfectly adequately with very nice low aperture lenses, f2 on the HTC Desire 500. Inside, it's Sense 5, and it is virtually identical, save for the customizations that we ourselves have made on the Desire. It's HTC One. Sense 5 coupled with Android 4.2 on the HTC One and Android 4.1 on the Desire 500. It's a slightly out of date version of Android, and we're not entirely sure if that's what it's going to end up with on the final unit. Hopefully, it won't. Internals are also extremely different. Quad-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 600 processor clocked at 1.7 GHz on the HTC One, one of the best performers out there, and with the optimizations HTC makes, Sense is absolutely flawless, as you can see, even a couple of months into use. The HTC Desire 500 has a 400 processor, that's Qualcomm Snapdragon 400, clocked at 1.2 GHz. Now, this isn't going to be worked out by this display. Packing half the pixels means you're putting half the pressure on the processor, so everything's still perfectly smooth. Gaming should be A-OK, but what's really going to inhibit your gaming performance on the HTC Desire 500 is the 4 GB, yes, 4 GB of internal memory. This will hardly be enough to get 2 or 3 decent games on there, like Nova 3, for example. The HTC One, in contrast, packs 32 or 64 gigabytes of memory, though isn't expandable, in contrast to the Desire 500. Remaining specs include RAM, 2 GB and 1 GB respectively, and that's pretty much it. The battery life of the HTC Desire 500 is yet to be tested, so we really can't say how it stacks up against the One. So all in all, that's our comparison. If you have any questions, please fire them in the comments section below, and we will endeavor to answer them for you. If you like this video, click like, and if you like the channel, please just click subscribe.